Hey y'all, it is time for a Sun Princess wrap-up update video.
We got here fast.
Mm-hmm. We have to put a period at the end of this sentence. Yes. So, if you were following along with the vlog series or our social media updates, you may already know we got delayed 2 days at sea to keep us safe while Hurricane Milton was approaching.
Yes.
So we're going to get into a little bit of that, and we're going to touch on our final thoughts, overall impressions, so stay tuned. Stick with us.
All that information.
All the information is coming. So the last 2 days of the cruise, because this was a 16-day that got extended to an 18-day, mm-hmm. We didn't really do a lot of recording.
Well, because they added things to the schedule, it was almost just like a regular sea day for them. Like, nothing was really impacting us on the ship. They took us to a safe location and just kept the entertainment and the fun going.
Yeah, so they really did a good job of making full schedules to keep everybody occupied.
Absolutely.
But let's throw it back. So here are the couple of updates that we tossed out on Instagram, just in case you missed those, pre-storm.
Yes.
Good morning, or possibly early afternoon from Sun Princess by the time we get this uploaded.
Yeah.
Just wanted to hop on and give a quick storm update, status update as to what is happening with Sun Princess right now.
We've had a lot of requests.
Yeah. That's true. So we are currently, well, let's see, what time is it right now?
It's noonish. 11:50 on October 8th.
So we are just floating off the coast of Fort Lauderdale. We can see it out the window. We might take you on the balcony and show you in a minute. But we've come this far because we had three medical evacuations of folks that needed to get ashore, because mm-hmm. Fort Lauderdale, Port Everglades is currently closed due to the impending storm, and the ship is not allowed in.
Yep.
So one evacuation was earlier via helicopter. We had the other ones were done with a little fireboat that mm-hmm. came out to the ship. Those are both, they're all done as far as we can tell, and we have now officially turned to the south to make a run down to the Bahamas and just kind of float around.
For an unknown amount of time.
Yeah, the plan is hopefully to get us back by Friday, but that's going to be dependent on the storm.
Exactly. So we're definitely praying for everybody who's in the path of the storm. You know, ours is not the biggest issue, but we do want to give you guys an update of what's going on. And we definitely feel for anybody who's having to do evacuations and board things up. And I really feel for a lot of the crew on here because it's the end of their contract when we get to Fort Lauderdale. And so that's being extended for them as well. And obviously any passengers on here who have homes in Florida as well. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so stay safe out there. We're going to try to do, we'll try to keep these little videos to maybe like 2 to 3 minutes tops. And if we need to record more than one, well,
we'll do that.
Keep it updated. So keep an eye on Facebook and Instagram, hopefully, for these posts.
Exactly.
Yeah, because the ship has actually responded really well. So I want to do a whole separate clip about what the ship has done to respond to the situation. Mm-hmm. But I guess that's it for now. So stay tuned.
We'll see you guys later.
More updates coming.
Bye.
We'll try to be a little bit quieter, but we're peeking off at Fort Lauderdale. You can tell we got balcony neighbors. I hear events happening up on Lido right now. So there it is, Port Everglades and Fort Lauderdale, tantalizingly close.
So close, yet so far away.
Yes, but we are happy to be out here mm-hmm. and safe. And again, wishing everyone in the path of this storm, well, I'll say both in the path of Helene and Milton?
Yes.
Just stay safe and continued recovery. And
if they tell you to evacuate, please, please evacuate.
Yeah. More updates soon. We'll update you as we hear stuff. Hey,
hello again.
Update. So ship preparedness. Is that the word?
That's a good word.
Ship response. Guest services was getting a whole heck of a lot of questions and long lines and things like that, obviously in uncertain times. So they sent a letter out with some highlights answering frequently asked questions. What have we learned most from this letter?
All right. So is there a possibility of reaching Fort Lauderdale before October 11th? No. Is it certain that we will dock in Fort Lauderdale on October 11th? No. If they booked with Easy Air, is Princess going to change their flights? Yes. Okay. Princess Plus and Premier will be extended to guests until disembarkation. They are not going to charge for crew appreciation on these extra days. You can cancel your transfer to Miami, and they're giving everybody complimentary internet to redo your travel plans, because obviously flights are being canceled and things like that. So good on Princess. They honestly did not have to do any of these things, but they're doing what they need to do to keep people happy.
So. Yeah. So, I mean, the extension of the beverage package, the extension of free internet and all of that at no extra cost.
Right.
Yeah. Any other highlights and thoughts? The crew actually has had an amazing response. We were at
A game show.
Yes, last night when the announcement came through from the captain, the big one, the first one that we were not going to make it back in time.
Yeah, and Niamh from Ireland was hosting it. She's one of the event staff, whatever you want to say there. And she jumped right on the microphone and was like, you know, we don't know this information until you guys do. And she went on to just talk about how it's going to be a stressful situation, but we just need to, like, you know, be friendly to each other. And she didn't miss a beat, basically.
Yeah.
And she was very calm about the whole thing. And then our Captain Craig Street, I believe his name, amazing updates. And I feel like we've been getting information in a very timely manner. So
yeah, I just like Neve's comment. She's like, we're here, we're safe, we've got tons of bars. let's do this. But
yeah, the crew has been phenomenal on the ship. And we're not paid by Princess anything like that. I always feel like you have to say that. But we just want to address that, you know, they're doing what they need to do.
October 9th, 2024, approximately 10-ish a.m. update. We are safely floating just off the coast of Cuba, between Cuba and the Bahamas. If you squint real hard, you might be able to see a little bit of Cuba over there. But this is our position, where we will float safely until the storm passes, and then reapproach Port Everglades, Fort Lauderdale. Date TBD for now.
Hey, we're back.
Yo, us again. So, some of the updates, I think, told part of the story, but let's just quickly go with what happened on these last couple of days. So, we made our approach to Fort Lauderdale. Mm-hmm. Fort Lauderdale closed the port down out of safety, but we did have some medical evacuations, which I think you just heard a little bit about. Was it two? Well, there were three total.
Three total, yeah.
One by helicopter and two by boat, I think is how it worked out. So, we got all of that safely done, then the captain turned us south, and we just floated between the coast of Cuba and the Bahamas and just stayed out of the way. So the waters down there were very calm.
So calm, you wouldn't have even known.
No. Yeah. And the spirits on board were generally good, I would say.
Yeah.
We didn't encounter a whole lot of people. Now, we had people that it was very unfortunate they couldn't get off the ship to go, like, prepare their homes.
Right, or they had family in Florida that they wanted to check on and surrounding areas. Yeah.
But, I mean, you know, understandably, we had to stay safely out at sea, and they kept us very safe. So, like I said, very calm, no wind and no waves where we were. So we felt very well taken care of in that aspect.
Yeah, and the crew was amazing. Mm. Like, they didn't miss anything.
Yeah, didn't miss a beat.
Didn't miss a beat at all, yeah. It was just like another sea day, and things just carried on.
Yeah. Now, I guess let's go ahead and throw it to shower chat, because you know we got to have shower chat, and then we'll be back with final thoughts. And now it is time for In the Shower with Jay, Sun Princess Edition. Let's peek it. So please excuse all the hissing air noise that is coming from the vent above me. But this is a nice glass door model, which is a definite improvement over other Princess showers. The only issue is that to open the door, oh my goodness, I'm kicking trash cans, I'm straddling the toilet. Okay, so you've got maybe not quite a foot of clearance, but to get the door open like that. All right. We have got a salami hanging rack. We have got easy to understand temperature and speed controls. We got grab bar. Nice Beekman 18012 in shower stuff. One snack shelf, which is sufficient, I guess. Nice removable, detachable, adjustable shower head with different settings. If you just twist the little thing there, clothesline all the way across, which is appreciated. Let's get in here. So with the door closed, the front back space is, it's okay. The side to side space is nice. The get downing room is nice. There's plenty, I don't know, it's a pretty spacious shower overall. Now, it does have one problem that requires you to sort of plan ahead with your showering. We've encountered this on other showers, but let's see, let's just pretend we've gotten in here. Woo, we've had a good time. We're all clean. Now we're ready to get out. Now we're opening the door. Oh, okay, let's reach for our towel. Oh no, the towels are behind the glass. I forgot to set my towel out ahead of time. So here I am, stepping out, dripping wet, reaching around the door to get my towel.
And yes, that is something that I will hold against the shower, because it's all part of the experience. We've had this on, I think it's the Edge class ships for Celebrity. Anyway, let's go to the spreadsheet, find a rating.
Hello.
Ooh, yeah.
We're here for our final thoughts, what you guys have probably been waiting for.
No, you know people were waiting for that shower chat number. That's what they tuned in for.
That is true.
Just kidding. So.
And so we can start with the cabin, because that ties into the shower.
There we go. Look at them segues.
I know.
All right.
So for the cabin overall, I really think they did a great job. Now, Princess is known for having like the giant closet, which takes up a lot of the bathroom space and on the like all their other ships. The closet wasn't as big, but there was ample storage in the room, and it lit up when you opened it. It was pretty cool.
Yeah, you had to make sure the doors were closed all the way, or the one light would never go off. So make sure your doors are clicked.
That's true.
Yeah, I was happy to give up a little bit of closet space, I guess, to have a larger bathroom. Because, you know, princess bathrooms and showers have been one of the banes of my existence for a while.
Yeah, but this one has a nice glass shower. They had separate shampoo and conditioner, which generally they do not. At least in our room it did. They had a dry bar hair dryer, which is like a very fancy brand, and you can buy it on the ship if you want to.
Lots I need one of those.
Outlets, the nice big couch in our room, but we did have a deluxe balcony.
True.
So it was just really light and airy. I don't know. I have no complaints about the room at all.
Yeah, the room was really nice. And like you said, the storage, it was adequate for what we needed. So approve. food and drink options. We're not really doing official categories,
no.
But just things to talk about. So how about food and drink?
So included food, it was really nice to see that they had a separate area from the eatery, which is the buffet, that you could go and get pizza or tacos or salad, and it wasn't everybody all in one area. And then on the promenade decks, they had the outdoor area with pizza and ice cream and hamburgers on the other side. So it was nice that they could break people up a little bit and you know, spread it out.
Yeah, like two different taco bar options, two burger places, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, also included is International Cafe. The menu is slightly different, but I feel like it's because we came from Europe, and so like the supplies are different. So once it got to Florida, I'm thinking it was more like what people are used to.
Yeah, anybody who's sailed since Florida, let me know. International Cafe, those morning breakfast sandwiches, did it go back to the Canadian bacon that I love? Because we had bacon, which was cool, but I missed my Canadian bacon.
Yeah.
Or ham, as it were. Oh, shots fired at Canadian bacon.
Oh, gosh. And then the dining room, you know, it was the dining room, and the food was really, really good in there. I actually really enjoyed the eatery for dinner. The buffet options were really, really tasty. So included food, I would give a thumbs up for sure.
True. And we understand that they've moved a lot of things around since we sailed. The diner concept has left Deck 8 and moved down to the back of the eatery. That was the space that normally there were a couple of specialty restaurants back there. Those have moved, and we don't even know where. So the ship is a little different since we even sailed it.
I know, craziness.
drinks especially, bar menus.
Yeah, so a ton of bars on Sun Princess. But the thing is really cool is that each bar basically has like their own specialty cocktails that they make there. Or you can get your everyday, you know, cocktails that everybody likes. But they're themed for the bar that they're presented at. And it will tell you if you buy Princess Plus or Premier, like what's included in each package. Or, of course, you can buy a la carte prices.
True. Yeah, the menus, they did make it really clear. It was almost like one section that was your Plus stuff, which is the one we lived off of. And then they had their super fancy ones. Yeah. And then there was the stuff that was not included on any package. I forget.
Yeah.
What did they call that? Extra or indulge or something
indulge,
like that?
Indulge, I think. But we found lots of favorites at several bars. I think the drinks were good. And the only thing, I guess, negative would be bar service in a lot of the areas, because I feel like the ship was slightly understaffed. They just didn't have the manpower to do it. So they sometimes would have one bartender at each bar, and then so nobody would be able to bring you drinks. But you also couldn't get to the bar because there were so many people, and you couldn't order on the app. But we'll talk about that later.
Yeah, I've got my list of negative points down here on the phone, but we're just kind of doing our general yays for right now.
Yeah.
Anyway, so food and drink, I think we're good there. But yeah, I guess having those different bar menus encourages you to like explore the ship and go to the different bars, and it gives you, I don't know, it's a good feeling.
Yeah.
So, entertainment overall?
So good.
Yeah, the shows especially, the main stage shows, and I mean, even the one we saw in the dome.
Yeah, so the shows are phenomenal. I've always liked Princess Entertainment. I think they've always been like a step above and like really trying to be innovative with their shows. And holy moly, they definitely did that on Sun Princess. The shows were great storytelling, the costumes were beautiful, singing and dancing, everything went together. And I recommend you go to the shows.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And let's see, public spaces in general was sort of our next thought.
So it's a lot different than on other ships. They don't have as many of the larger lounges that you might be used to for kind of hanging out with friends. There's a lot of smaller areas, like the venues in general are smaller. What do you think about
them? You would hang out, your hangout zones become Bellini's, Crooners, right. These kinds of places. You've still got Princess Live.
That's a little bit bigger.
But yeah, I miss the sort of aft lounge concept because we didn't really have that on here, right? The either the Vista Lounge or the whatever it's called on the other ships.
Yeah,
places to just sit around and chat are definitely far and few between, I would say. Yeah. And then the dome is kind of a hangout spot during the day, but then they would need to shut the dome down either for rehearsals, and it's obviously closed toward the evenings because of the dome shows. So the dome is not really super, super fun. Functional all day long.
And then they have the piazza seating, which is three different levels, but it fills up so fast because they're doing events in there all day long. So that's about it for seating areas.
Not bad, but not fantastic for big groups to hang out, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. Do we get into the bullet points now?
Go for it.
And then I'll just kind of, we'll just give a wrap up after that. So now these are just random. There's no particular order to these.
No.
I'm going to try to group them.
We just kind of made notes as we were on the ship.
As we went. So here's what I typed into my phone as we cruised. Number one, small show venues.
Yeah. So as great as the shows are, they did not build to the capacity of the ship. Now, you can never build a theater for 5,000 people, but I think it's about 920 seats in the main theater, and if that ship is full, they do three shows.
Yeah.
Only like half of the ship, if that, is going to get to see the shows.
Yeah.
And so people got word of that and started lining up hours early for the shows, and that's the big theater. And then the dome is about 250 people, and they do about three shows.
Yeah, even if they do four, that's still not good math.
Yeah, so it kind of feels like an exclusivity type of a venue. Like, I feel like they could have definitely done more and made it a larger venue. The dome, for sure.
Yeah, the dome, and that's why we only went to the one show. I mean, it was great, but after we saw the one, it just wasn't worth lining up for in the wait for us.
No, because we wanted to, like, enjoy the ship and show you guys more, and we would be standing in line just being like, here's a wall, you know?
And we've done that on other ships.
We have,
now, if I'm allowed to compare across brands.
Yeah, yeah.
To me, the dome concept is a little bit like Eden on the Edge Class ships of Celebrity.
That's fair.
We go really early to Eden and score those seats so that we can get some sight lines, but Eden is open all the time. We're allowed to just go in there and sit for 2 hours if we feel like it. Whereas the dome shows, I think you can go into the bar maybe and wait.
Yeah, there's a tip that I think, I don't know if they're going to change this, but if you're in the bar area before they close it to the general public and start the line, they'll let you stay in there and you're like in line at that point. But then they start counting and I don't know how they know how many people are inside. So that's probably going to go away. I don't know.
Who knows? But otherwise you're standing in a line for an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours, and that's not that fun. And we heard of actual fisticuffs on our sailing over dome seating. We didn't see it.
We did not witness it.
We heard about it, like actual physical violence over the seating.
Oh, another tip for the actual production shows in the theater is the matinee was never as busy as the evening shows.
True.
So if you're good with a matinee show, which is what we did typically, you should be able to get good seats.
Yeah, we preferred it because we were out doing other stuff in the evenings, and then boom, see that matinee.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see if I can combine all of these. These were my app thoughts.
Ah.
Lack of order now choices. Now, I pointed it out in the video. When you go into the app, you can normally have any array of cocktails delivered to you wherever you are on the ship. There was like three martinis and one cocktail, which was the Baked Alaska. That was the only stuff, other than like straight up liquors, that they could have delivered. So many things were missing.
Yeah, it was weird.
I don't know.
If they could make that one martini that had like 18 ingredients in it, I didn't quite understand the logic, but we were told it was because of staffing.
Yeah.
So if you've been on it since we've been on it,
please
let us know if they added more, because you're paying for that service, and people who have been on Princess before are accustomed to that. You know, it's part of Princess Plus, Princess Premier, or you can just pay for ordering on the app.
Yeah, because order now, if you remember, used to be completely free.
It did.
It does now have a dollar value assigned to it. So for the dollar value that is now on it, it was worth zero on our cruise.
Yeah.
Other than we had some food delivered. I did appreciate it. It was worth $2.
Fine. Yeah, the food delivery was fine. Drinks, no.
That was weird, yeah. The other things that we noticed is sort of deck 8, especially in the piazza, is an ordering dead zone. You cannot have things delivered to deck 8. 7 is fine. Mm-hmm. 9 is fine. But 8, no. It's not even an option.
Which is strange because Crooner's Bar is on 8. Mm. So there is a bar there and there's a coffee shop just above and below. But they're not able to find you for some reason with your medallion.
Yeah, I've never really known. I mean, I know like the theater has always been a dead zone, and like I think like the gym, there's places where you can't have things delivered.
Exactly.
But I've never heard of like part of the piazza being a dead zone. So that was new to me. Mm-hmm. Let's see, what are my other app things? Okay, yeah, I tried to see could I have coffee delivered to me on deck 7. That was sort of a struggle because for some reason I ordered it on deck 7 where Coffee Currents is, and they sent the order up to deck 9 to International Cafe, and the gentleman had such a hard time finding me. He did eventually find me. And I also did, you may have seen, the water experiment where at Zumba I was sitting on deck 7, which is an approved zone, and on October 2nd I tried to order 2 bottles of water. I had to place the order 5 times before they came and found me with my bottled water. On October 5th I placed an order for 4 bottles of water. It took 6 orders for them to finally bring that water. They kept just marking it as delivered, mm-hmm. even though they never found me, and then I would place it again, they would mark it as delivered. One time they just canceled it, and so I put it in again. Finally my water came. It was mostly for you, Zumba girl.
Yeah. So, and this wasn't to make the staff work harder. No. We don't do this for that reason, but we're doing it because, you know, we want to put the information out there. How are things working on a new ship? Is it working? And that was not working.
Yeah, they were struggling. So, we were just curious to know. Okay, that was all of my app things.
Okay.
Let's see what else is on the list. I had International Cafe breakfast food changes. We talked about that. Mm-hmm. That was the bacon and the stuff like that specifically. Yeah. I made this note. Dome is hot. That was after the loyalty party where I almost melted. That is a greenhouse and it traps the heat in there.
Somebody said that they do have air conditioning.
Please turn it on.
It's not working for our loyalty party, but it's glass ceiling. It's definitely like a greenhouse.
It was very hot. Yeah. Small slopes around piazza. Now, this is multiple princess ships.
Oh.
The round area in the middle, not the thing that comes up and down, but the whole area, there are little slopes that go up. The floor is not completely level. So many people, including me, you, bumped our feet. We knew it was there. We would still trip. We would hit our feet, our shoes, squeak, squeak, up we go.
Yeah.
It's not just this ship, but please pick up your feet when you're walking across the piazza because you will find that little slope.
You don't even realize it until you're like almost falling. It's a little strange.
I had buffet does not repeat, which means that as you walk around the buffet line, you have to go around the entire section to see all of the food.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of like the ones where you go in and you can do half the buffet and you've seen everything because it repeats on the other side. But this one, you did need to make a full loop. Now, not that that's bad. You've got more choices.
Options, yeah.
But it just made it to where you had to encounter more people and more lines to get what you wanted.
That's just smallish space, too.
We're just nitpicking at this point. This is just me, y'all. Here's another one.
Oh.
Automatic sinks.
Oh my gosh.
Combination soap dispenser and water sink. Sorry, let me put my phone down because I have to do a demonstration.
They're like the bane of our existence, really.
I appreciate them. But now what would happen is I would walk up to the sink, I would put my hand under the soap side, goosh, water would turn on and turn off, and my hand would fill up with 5 cups of soap. It was okay. That's an exaggeration. And then I'm like, all right, give me my water. Nothing. Water, nothing, nothing, nothing. I had to literally take my hands completely away, step back, and go, whoo, and then the water would activate. I don't know what I was doing wrong.
You have
sure
to scare
it's me.
It.
You have to frighten the sink. This is probably a me thing
and
not a sink thing.
I heard everyone talking about
these
things.
I could not. Please, any bathroom, the public bathrooms usually had one sink with a regular handle and a pump soap. I would always use that thing. Those soap dispensers and water got me every time.
They mean well. It's just an interesting design choice.
Yeah. We had open air crooners and wheelhouse. That was just the restructuring of some of these bars, which are usually cozy and intimate spaces, into like... Because, you know, your piano bar, I feel like, is normally something you can go cozy up in.
And like a sing-along bar. It's not like that.
No, true.
Not at all.
Because it's open-air piazza, and I don't know if that would annoy people, especially Sweet Caroline. That would just annoy the heck out of anybody.
So it's a different feel on there for that, yeah.
Yeah, and wheelhouse is usually, I feel like, kind of an enclosed, cool little space, and it's basically a walk-through. But the funny thing is, they called it the quiet reading room during certain times of day, but it's literally like... there's a hallway running through it. So good luck finding quiet in the reading room. And then the sort of the last thing I was going to point out is we discovered the approximate battery life of a medallion after about day, I'll say 15 or 16, my battery died. Yours died on, I think, the last day. So just about 2 weeks, and the batteries died. We were locked out of our cabin.
We just came back from Zumba, sweaty and hot, and like trying to get in the room. It was quite comical.
Yeah, our steward had gone off to do something in the office, but she did eventually come back and let us in.
Yeah.
We went down to guest services. They weren't able to, their machine was down or something, and they couldn't give us a new medallion, but they gave us cards to open our door. But the bad thing about that is my medallion was stuck showing that I was in my room the entire rest of the cruise, and yours was in the hallway. So we couldn't have things delivered to us because the medallion didn't know where we were. It was the
first world problems.
Yeah, it was.
But it was funny. Yeah.
Real first world problems. That's the end of my picky list.
Okay.
But final thoughts. Let's wrap this sucker up. Put a bow on it.
Okay. So final thoughts are, I love Princess Cruise Line. Mm-hmm. I think they did a fantastic job with all of the hurricane stuff.
Yeah,
first and foremost, the crew was amazing. The captain kept us really informed. I will always be a Princess Cruiser because of that, and they treated their guest amazingly. The ship itself, I like a lot of what they did, but if you're used to certain things on Princess, it's going to be very hard to get used to a lot of the changes. Mm-hmm. The crew was phenomenal. The food was really good. The shows were great. It's just some of the spaces kind of left me like, huh. I, as a travel advisor, would personally not recommend a group cruise on that ship. Mm. There's just nowhere to really hang out with each other that you don't feel like you're taking over the entire venue. That's my thoughts on it.
True. I'll say again, just as a side note, Deck 19, I still wish that Princess had stuck to their guns, and because if you know the history of this ship, it was originally supposed to have this Deck 19 area with like splashy slides, some kind of coaster thing, a ropes course, and like a kid area. This was really Princess's foray into family cruising, which is not something they've really tried to get into before. They've never been a family cruise line. They've always welcomed families,
right?
But they've never been a family cruise line. And I think they got so much negative response from the diehard Princess Cruisers that they were like, we got to take those slides off. People, they don't want a ropes course. What do we do with this space? I wish that they had just put the tackiest, gaudiest water park up on top of that ship. I would have loved to have seen what would have happened.
Yeah.
That's just me. That's just my thoughts. Princess, please, you know what? Go back up on Deck 19. Rebuild that whole course. Put it on there. Just do it. See what happens.
Or do it for Star.
Yeah. So now, my final thoughts on the ship is I have to approach this from two ways. As a diehard Princess Cruiser, so if you're looking at the ship as a Princess Cruiser, I appreciate a lot of the new things that they've done. This is their foray into the, you know, mega ship and all of that stuff. But as a Princess Cruiser, a lot of things flopped, and this goes definitively to the bottom of my Princess ship list, just for me personally. I guess approaching it as somebody who is just, you know, kind of loves all cruising, which is who I actually am, and is, you know, curious to see these new things develop and unfold. It's not a bad ship. There's a lot to like about it, just thinking in terms of a general cruiser. So it's a good ship overall. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. That's my final thought is I don't know. How about that?
Nice. No, and I think the activities on the ship were really fun. They did a great job like new activities and keeping everybody entertained. I do know for a fact that the sister ship, Star Princess, is going to be doing Alaska. Mm. I don't know how it's going to do cold weather-wise, because there's a lot of outdoor space on these classes, but indoor space is very limited, and if everyone's inside, that's going to be an issue. Yeah, so I don't know how I feel about that.
That's interesting.
That's just a random thought.
Put the water slides back on there. They'll go well in Alaska. Come on now. Yeah, that is it. We have talked long enough. Thanks for hanging out for this mostly chatty video.
But hope you got something out of it.
We needed to at least put a pin, because we're getting ready to start a new series this coming Monday, if you're watching this video when it comes out. Ping, ping, put a pin in this and say, yay, Sun Princess.
Yes.
I'm glad we tried it.
Oh, yeah.
We do have a future sailing booked on it, so we're going to get to see her again.
We are.
Eventually. We won't really talk about that one yet, but shh, don't tell anybody. We're going on Sun Princess again. That's all I know.
Yeah.
So thanks so much for watching.
Thanks for sticking it out with us.
That's true. Sticking that pin. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Become a Paromaniac today. Socialize all our media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
Yep. And until next time,
rock on.